Packer will have you at courtside from Maryland to Michigan. Enjoy the game, everybody. We'll talk to you later.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship Regional Semifinal Game is sponsored by Saturn, Budweiser, and by Doritos Tortilla Benz.
Now, every company in America that switches to MCI will get a check that doubles their savings every time they get a proof positive statement this year. Surely, one of these checks has your name on it.
You know which motor oil can help keep your car running for 100, 200, 300,000 miles and more? It's the same brand that more top mechanics in America use in their own cars. Valvoline motor oil.
People who know use Valvoline.
Just down Sunset and up the incredible California coast is Wolfgang Puck's latest culinary creation, Granita. It's a touch of the Mediterranean with a dash of the Pacific. And if you go there, bring your appetite for travel and your Visa card.
It's perfect.
Because Wolfgang's grilled prawns will take you to the Mediterranean, but Granita won't take American Express.
I love to cook, and I love to eat even more.
Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
To Dallas, the Midwest Regional Semifinal. About to go, it's Maryland against Michigan. The Maryland Terrapins, the 10th seed in the Midwest against the number 3 seed Michigan. Arkansas awaits in the regional final on Sunday. Welcome back again, everybody. Jim Nance along with Billy Packer. And Billy, let's get right to it. Inside, quite a matchup. Juwan Howard has been spectacular for the Wolverines in this tournament.
He really has been. First team all Big Ten, and like Glenn Robinson, he's put his team on his back and really carried them in this NCAA tournament. Had his all-time high in scoring the last game. Great low post player.
But he will be matched up against the best freshman in the country, Joe Smith of Maryland.
This is one of the classic matchups of Joe Smith playing way beyond his years in terms of the way he goes about the game. The leading scoring freshman in the country, as well as the leading rebounding freshman in the country. All ACC first team.
Gotta love the matchup. We talked to the coaches, Steve Fisher and Gary Williams. We got their perspective on this game tonight.
Maryland is a team on a nice roll right now. They are very athletic. They do a great job with their press. And they've got the ability to attack you inside and put you in foul trouble. They shot 55 free throws in their first two games in the tournament. Concerns me, foul trouble and handling the press.
Well, for us, we have to play with confidence. We've done a good job of that so far in the tournament, and we have to continue to do that. And the other thing is, if we can limit Michigan to one shot and not let them get the ball inside, I think we'd be in good shape.
Starting lineups, Maryland with two freshmen, Smith and Booth, and three sophomores. For Michigan, it's the Fab Four plus five. And let's bring in our colleague Jim Gray before we tip it. Jimmy?
All right, thank you very much, Jim. I spoke with Gary Williams, the head coach of Maryland. He said the first 5 minutes of this game is imperative to his team. He said we cannot allow Michigan to jump off to a fast start, because if we do, that could be very demoralizing to our young team. So what Williams is going to have his team do from the opening tap is press and pressure the ball when Michigan has it. Jim?
And the officials include Larry Limbo, along with David Hall, William Sanchez. Michigan having defeated Pepperdine in overtime, and Texas. Maryland with victories over St. Louis and UMass, the 2 seed, and Michigan controls the start.
Big man and hip on Jalen Rose. For the few times Jalen will be guarded by a guy his size in the backcourt.
Ray Jackson, he has been hot, Billy, and just like last year, he brings his game to a new level in the NCAA.
First two games in the NCAA last year, at 19, both games, played extremely well. He's known as a defender, but caught his offense up.
Hit with a two inside the arc.
And here's that press by Maryland. One, a diamond and one, Joe Smith all the way back.
Rose steals it. He is a specialist in that department. 4-2 Maryland.
He's led the ACC in steals 2 years in a row, setting Maryland school records.
Can't believe how easy that one was to steal.
Too easy. Juwan Howard, the steadying influence, comes back with those good hands.
Jimmy King and Ray Jackson back in their home state of Texas. Good hustle by Smith, but it's Michigan basketball.
That's going to be a matter, Jim, I think, of which one of those two players on the inside get in foul trouble. Both playing against each other, Juwan Howard and Joe Smith. Neither team can afford to lose the power inside.
Howard called for traveling.
And what's interesting about them, in, as far as the way they play defense, is completely different. Juwan Howard is not a shot blocker. He's a position defender. Joe Smith, on the other hand, incredible shot blocker. He's blocked more shots this year than the whole Maryland team did last year. Got 90 coming into this game.
Smith, in and out. Rose wants to run with it. And to King, pull-up jumper. Ties it.
Isn't it funny to look at Michigan and how time flies in front of the Fab Five? And here they are playing against a younger team than they are. You know, now they're the juniors. They're the old guys in the rocket chair.
Only yesterday we were marveling at how they made it all the way to the finals. As freshmen. Goes underneath.
Runs the floor so beautifully. And he made a name for himself in the first game of his college career going up against Georgetown. A big win for Maryland that set the stage for their early success.
And they made a statement right out of right out of the gate.
A little spread offense now by Michigan.
Howard.
Booth actually took Jackson to the hole that time, didn't he? Overpowered him. Some shot inside. Jim Keith Boot, Maryland Player of the Year.
Ray Jackson.
And he is a first cousin of Donda Bright, who plays for Massachusetts.
The basket is good.
The team they knocked out earlier in this tournament. Power player.
He is the first recruit at Maryland from Baltimore Dunbar High School. Since Ernest Graham.
Ernest, who still holds the Maryland single game scoring record. Great outside shooter.
King thought about a three. Now he hits the two instead.
Jimmy started to come back, but kind of an off year for him offensively compared to what was expected with Chris Webber leaving his lineup. Good defense by Rose.
Rebounder he is for his size.
Not against Juwan Howard.
Well, he got one in there. But Howard secured the other one. Three-pointer. Jackson keeps it alive. And slap from behind by Rose. Johnny Rose commits his first.
Let's think about the pace of this game a little bit, Jim. Neither team has a defense. Effective, but not defense.
One on Maryland.
This is the way that Maryland likes to play, so it's their tempo.
Two for Jackson.
Great game against Texas to bring him to the Sweet 16. 15 points. 14 rebounds and 7 assists.
Flirted with the old triple-double. Yep. Like last year when he had a top-notch game against UCLA in the tournament.
Right?
He had a season high. That game though against Texas may have been the best for Jackson's career. From Austin, capital of this state.
And Juwan Howard really putting an arm on Smith inside.
Right, and that's good.
Smart play by by Booth. He knew he was going to be fouled, so he gave up the shot to make sure that the foul was called.
They call it on Ray Jackson.
Ray Jackson.
That's a smart play.
That's two on Jackson, Billy, and he has fouled out in the last three games for the Wolverines, and already with two here in the first 3.5 minutes.
So last year, Michigan almost could not get into foul trouble because of the tremendous depth they had. But now they can ill afford to lose any of these starters.
Here we go, let's go.
Weakest free throw to shooter on the Maryland team, just at 60%.
And he's missed all three of his attempts here in the early action.
Nice curl move by Jamie.
Hip stole it. He reached in. Hip spins free for two.
X3 has got great quickness and tremendous leaping ability.
Dangerous pass.
And almost Rhodes picking off another one.
And that was Booth forcing that one free.
And Joe Smith showing some of his ability in the open court. Juwan Howard really hustling back on defense.
What a shooting show the Terrapins put on against UMass.
In this tournament, they've been just hitting the lights out. 60% that one.
Double up on Booth. Finds the open man. One of the head.
Rhodes had no idea Juwan was there.
Three-pointer, Jackson off the mark. King over the back. Officials timeout. Michigan and Maryland, we've had two ties at 2-4-6 in eight.
A tradition unlike any other. The Masters on CBS. This is what basketball used to be like. Now it's all fast breaks and slam dunks. Well, things change. Check out the Achieva Special Edition from Oldsmobile. With anti-lock brakes, airbag, air, automatic, and more, it's all running and gunning for just $13,995. Yeah. The Achieva Special Edition. It's a 360 slam dunk. It's your money.
In the preseason, don't get out much. But come spring, there's nothing more relaxing than a little walk in the park.
All men are created equal. Some just work harder in the preseason.
Okay, classic cars.
63 Vets.
Split window.
Right.
68 Camaro Super Sport.
GTO, any year.
Nice. Gran Torino.
Starsky and Hutch. Good car.
65 Mustang Raptor.
It's obvious.
75 Pacer.
Tailfin.
Bumper bullets.
Bench seats.
Drive-ins.
Boss 302. 427 big block LED 8 with an 850 double pump.
Beechwood aged Budweiser. Crisp, clean, and classic.
What do you get when you cross a high-quality conventional motor oil with an advanced formula synthetic? A revolutionary new oil that protects better than regular oils, yet costs 40% less than full synthetics. DuraBlend from Valvoline. People who know use Valvoline.
If every company in America switched to MCI, American business would save over $1 billion a year. That's a lot of fax machines.
You are watching the NCAA Basketball Championship on CBS.
Well, Eddie Sutton's the all-time leader with 14, but Gary Williams in this list. Gary at Maryland, hey, that's where Lefty coached. Hey, you know who his assistant was? George Raveling. You know who Gary replaced? Eldon Miller at Ohio State. Little combination there between some of the guys that have been involved taking three or more, Jim.
Pitino and Sutton.
Pitino and Sutton at Kentucky. Company there. It's been a fine ball game. You know, these teams match up so well personnel-wise.
Too high over the top of the hoop. first Maryland turnover. Olivier St. John in for Michigan. He tips it up once, and Booth gets the rebound for Maryland.
Booth showing some real strength inside, Jim. He's overpowered some people on some offensive rebounds. Defense rebound. Two jumpers in a row for Hip. And there's that diamond press again.
3 points.
Stolen by Hip. They call it against him.
St. John doing all that he could just to draw the charge. This was a good anticipation. You see, getting right back in there. X-Ray not in a position to pull up with his little jump stop.
Michigan having trouble with this.
They got to throw over the top of it. There it is.
Howard. Howard again.
Good boxing out by Michigan. They just had the inside position on short rebounds. Maryland couldn't wedge their way in. Joe Smith has not been able to touch the ball. The great position defense that we talk about by Juwan Howard probably plays that low post defense as well as anybody.
Rhodes. Air ball.
Felt like he got pushed underneath. But Jalen doesn't want any part of it. Again, now look at this diamond in one. They can throw over the top of this to Jalen and take off for the break. Here it is.
It's for 3-on-2.
Former quarterback.
Yep.
Jalen Rose made that by smart penetration to the inside. Sucked the defense in. They fight the wide open shot.
Hit block by St. John.
Joe Smith never did see it inside. Had Rhodes and Booth open. Little one-on-one penetration for Simpson.
Against the boot. Booth tied him up for a second, no call. And with one on the shot clock, Booth fired it up again and drew the foul.
Now Booth has established himself as the power man inside. We saw a power game in the first game with Arkansas. Guys taller and even bulkier.
Foul number four.
That's what it's going to take.
Keith Booth, two shots.
And here you have the youthful Turks. Jerry Williams really turning this program around. Not a senior out there. You know, the club they beat, Massachusetts, they don't have a senior either. So a lot of,
it's like UConn leading by six at the half. They had a senior, one senior on the team, and he played 1 minute the whole season. So if Marshall comes back, that whole team will return.
And, you know, it's not like Arkansas is loaded with upperclassmen either when you start talking about quality teams to return. Booth misses his fourth straight foul shot.
Bring in Mario Lucas.
Lucas in for Maryland.
Lucas coming off a terrific ball game. Actually, probably the guy that got Maryland here with a great play off the bench that they so sorely needed.
So this is St. John takes it home.
A man who wanted to go to the University of North Carolina. Great acquisition for Steve Fisher.
Five reached in, knocked it loose. They like to joke on the Maryland bench. How fast, when Lucas comes into the game, will he launch one? This is their first trip. He had a big game against UMass. Simpkins.
John is really doing a job, isn't he?
Good in there.
Yep. Active. So far, both postmen have been quiet.
And Joe Smith backs Jalen Rose. Smith has attempted only one shot in the first almost 8 minutes.
But Jimmy hasn't been able to touch the ball because Juwan Howard doing such a good job. A little pick and roll that time. Juwan normally would look for the dump back by Rose, but tough to get that ball over Joe Smith.
Jalen with some clutch free throw shooting in this tournament, made his last seven against Pepperdine and his last seven attempts against Texas.
Had 12 assists in those two games, but did turn the ball over a little bit more than this year. He's done a tremendous job with his assist turnover ratio the last 2 years. And although he had a lot of assists, he turned the ball over equal number of times. Doing much better this year with his collection of passes.
St. John had it. Rhodes gets in. Here comes Maryland.
Juwan Howard hustling again. Second time in this game he's got back in time to stop a break.
Yeah, he's safe too.
Yep, for sure.
And John with the body.
So often you see that against a man-to-man out of bounds. Just the two screeners on the inside, the screener coming back to the ball. Lucas was wide open.
DJ Sanjee called for his second personal foul, 15th foul on Michigan.
Michigan leading 15-12. Joe Smith has two for Maryland. Made his only field goal attempt. And now a sub in for Michigan, Maktar Injai.
Young man who attended Wake Forest University for the first semester, ruled ineligible to play there. Came to Michigan and was immediately eligible.
Simpkins. Oh, up and over.
Young man from DeMatha.
Injai just throws it away.
Well, now you've got to question something here. Steve Fisher has a man taking the ball out of bounds that's the least experienced player he has against a very effective press. That's not going to work.
Maryland can take the lead here. Lucas, there he goes, Byron. And Rose secures it for the Wolverines.
Jim, I think both of these clubs are going to have to show they can get the ball to their man in the low post. Joe Smith is going to have to start touching the ball more when he gets back into the game. The same with Juwan Howard.
Look at the hands of Rose. Just picked his pocket. Simpkins ahead.
Tremendous pass. You know, Rose not only with a great steal, that was the only pass he could throw. High in the air and let Simpkins run under it.
Howard, bounce pass over to Rose and one.
Great hands by Jalen. He was going full speed. Picked that up off the ground. You see the hands right here of Jalen Rose. Watch this. Full speed. Picks it up with one hand. Scoops it on into the basket. Obviously, his strong hand being his left, but still a great catch and put up.
Nick Bosnick, freshman from Uniontown, Pennsylvania, in for Maryland. 6'7" freshman. Michigan with seven field goals and seven turnovers. The Wolverines lead by two.
Mr. Gooden?
That's right.
Any relation to Dwight Gooden?
None at all.
No, okay. Do you have time for a couple of questions?
Short ones.
Tell us about your HP LaserJet printer.
My LaserJet?
Yeah, what do you think about it?
I don't.
Ever?
LaserJets work. What's there to think about?
But if you did?
I don't.
But if you did?
Well, if I had to think about it, I probably wouldn't have one.
But you do have one.
No, I have two.
Oh.
Is that enough?
Works for me. HP LaserJet printers. You do your job, we'll do ours.
Good idea.
GTE introduces something incredible. It can transmit and receive data with digital clarity. It can fax and receive faxes from anywhere in the world. It can even access financial news and weather and conduct three-way conference calls. But what's most impressive is that it does it all at 35,000 feet. GTE Airphone reaches far beyond what people expect. Another way, it's amazing what we can do together.
For a diehard fan, watching the NCAA championship can be pretty stressful. Which is why we at Oldsmobile recommend that if you're going to watch for the next 2 weeks, you consider getting an 88 LSS. With all kinds of relaxing comforts to help you take your mind off the stress of the world outside. You see, if you had an LSS right now, you wouldn't be nearly so tense. It's your money.
Thinking about getting a pizza?
Yeah.
But hey, don't get up. Call Pizza Hut. We'll deliver it. We deliver everything, from the Super Supreme with 9 delicious toppings to the legendary value Bigfoot.
Bigfoot!
Because we've got just the pizza you want, just the way you want it, and we'll deliver it right to your door. And now for the ultimate delivery, the ultimate pepperoni pizza, new from Pizza Hut. Zesty herbs, thicker pepperoni for a whole new taste. Get one delivered today, and remember, one bite and there's no going back.
Monday, Georgie and her spy expose a secret men's club.
This looks like a tape recorder. It's a heart monitor combination tape recorder.
Hearts of Fire after Murphy Brown Monday.
Well, we talked about the Smith-Howard matchup. Kind of neutralized one another so far. X-ray hip, 3 for 3 from the floor. Michigan, like we saw Philly with Georgetown in the Big East tournament, bringing its huddle out onto the floor, way out on the floor near the free throw area during the timeouts. That's a change from last year.
Yeah, I think that it's an interesting move by coaches, because when you go and play on foreign courts, that's not true here in the NCAA, but where you have that crowd screaming at you all the time, I think it gets your players to really focus in on the timeout situation.
Michigan back with a starting five. Subs Bosnick and Lucas in for Maryland. They take away from Lucas. Rose, the lob from Rose, and Howard couldn't finish it.
Jawan running the court on both ends.
Got a pass in there. Simpkins tried to force it.
Gary Williams getting ready to come back with him. Right now, their offense doesn't have that inside presence, so Michigan really shutting down. This Michigan defense is much better now than the ones that went to the Final Four. Jalen was waiting for his partner to catch up, and there it goes, off with the right hand. Look at how dead that ball is. It was perfect, no spin on it at all. Juwan probably should have caught it with two hands.
Bosnick called on the foul, by the way. And hit back for Maryland. Jimmy Keane has always been terrific on those lob plays, finishing them off.
Yeah, he catches them with two hands and flushes them away. And that's what Juwan should have done on that last play. Howard's getting superior position. He just can't get in the ball. He's wide open. There he is.
Now turn around.
Juwan fought for position and had.
Booth caught him napping. They had their backs turned.
Nobody picked up Booth. If you're Maryland, tied score halfway through the first half, Joe Smith not even touching the ball, you got to feel kind of good.
Juwan this time gets it to drop.
That's his shot. 12 feet turnaround jumper. Remember, his first big game in his career was against Indiana.
On the road, yep. As a freshman. Had like 26, I think, Billy. Yep. Tough shot, but he got it to go. Booth has 7.
He's having a big game off the boards, too, Kim. He's just been shocking people down on the defensive rebounding.
Sixth tie of this first half. Rose.
Jalen puts that head down, makes you think he's going to try to penetrate, and pulls back for that unusual jump shot.
Now look at Rose with the rebound at that end. Jackson. Good rotation on that one, Billy.
Jalen with two great plays. Hits the jumper, and then looks ahead to see Ray Jackson after grabbing a great rebound.
Michigan with its largest lead, a 4-point advantage.
Jalen missing by only a few votes, being first-team All-American. So it shouldn't be unusual to see him making these great plays. And they can't get Joe Smith free. Juwan Howard gets the switch back.
Good. Nick Bosnick. He's a 31% three-point shooter. And Jackson with his third. And 8 minutes remaining in the first half.
Again, dribble down and dish out. The best way to get a three-point shot off. And Jim, the number three is bad for Michigan on that play all the way around. A three-point basket and three on Ray.
And it was 3 seconds on the shot clock. But he made it. And hit. Well, Mike for Michigan. Wolverines lead by one.
Takes out Juwan Howard as well, so he's very inexperienced on the floor right now.
And over the back, Injai called for the foul. Let's see how active Smith is on the offensive end with Howard getting a rest.
Well, I sure think it's a good time to try to get it down inside. Juwan out of the ball game has played a terrific game as usual on the defensive end. Just hasn't let Joe Smith touch the ball. They're already in the 1-1, right?
Personal foul number one.
Indeed. That's seven against Michigan.
And Steve Fisher said at the top of the show, Maryland's been getting to the foul line a lot. And here they are in 1-1 with almost 8 minutes to go in the first half.
Won't be a long rest for Howard. He's already at the scorer's table and will check in. That's the first point for Smith. I was thinking he had made his one field goal attempt, but in fact it went in and out.
Right, so, it was that jumper from the corner.
So the first point for Smith, it took him 12 minutes, Billy. The two free throws puts the Terrapins on top.
Enjoying the championship so far? Well, how'd you like to do a little skying of your own? No problem. With an Achieva Special Edition from Oldsmobile, you can take off anytime. Loaded with anti-lock brakes, airbag, air, automatic, and more for just $13,995, you'll be playing way above the rims. Why should you? It's your money.
Dear car owners, if you had a brake problem tomorrow, could you think of one brake specialist to go to? Where can you go for same-day brake service? A guarantee on brake shoes and pads for as long as you own your car. And the expertise of doing over 2 million brake jobs a year? Midas.
Think of us as the brake specialists. We're pretty good at mufflers, too.
Barbecue chicken sandwich already has so many fans. It's at KFC to stay.
Folks can't get enough of those strips of chicken smothered in a tangy honey barbecue sauce.
Of course, the introductory $1.49 price makes it really tempting.
Plus, $1.49 barbecue chicken sandwich forever.
The sandwich is here to stay, but the $1.49 is for a limited time.
We are KFC. We do chicken.
Imagine a processor that's not just about more power. It's about an entirely new kind of PC. One that responds instantly to whatever you ask of it. One that breathes new life, a new spark into all your software. That's the power of the Pentium processor. From Intel, the computer inside.
Will Wood lead Evening Shade to coach in the NFL?
I'm all for it. As much as any wife can be for something that might possibly rip her family apart.
Well, she's sold.
All new Monday.
Jalen Rose, the sixth all-time scorer at Michigan, moving in on Rudy T. That includes tonight's 5 points.
Look at some of those names on there. The great Cassie Russell, Glenn Rice, who we talked about. He set the all-time NCAA scoring record. He had 184 points in 89. And Glenn Robinson with 104 and half as many games on his tail.
Donnie Rhodes, his second personal foul.
He's second on Rhodes. His sixth team foul, so Michigan will inbound. This game has had seven ties, seven lead changes. The biggest lead for Maryland, 3. The biggest lead for Michigan, 4.
Off the leg, and hit Enzi right in the leg. Is that Johnny Rhodes again with those quick hands of his? Although he didn't get credit for his steal, he turned it over. I still think Maryland, Jim, in the next 7:40, have got to figure out a way to get Joe Smith the ball down low. He just has not been able to touch it. Way above the rim on that block.
That's the second on King. I don't know. Billy, tell me. What do you see here?
Well, player control foul. But look at him. There's no question in terms of the block, but the call was the foul of the charge before the block. The block was legit. We'll see Simpkins sitting right down. He's got position and
barely
fades on out. Hardly touched
him. Barely touched
him. Yep. Michigan probably doubles down on the low post better than anybody in college basketball, although I was really impressed with Arizona last night and what they did going down on in Louisville's situation, not giving them any opportunity in the low post.
So
Clifford
Rozier.
Rozier
really had a hard time handling it inside.
It was just great defense by Arizona, and every time it went down there, they were having guys doubling from various areas. Louisville could never adjust.
One and one.
That was the second on Lucas. And Howard will shoot a one and one. He's 2 out of 6 from the field.
Well, Jim, in 14 NCAA tournament games, Juwan has averaged 16.1 points and 7.3 rebounds. It's been spectacular. In the last year, he was all Western Regional. Just played great there. Played great in the Final Four as well. Had that outstanding game against Doray when they knocked off GW.
He doesn't give you many off nights.
No season.
Tonight he's doing it on the defensive end. In there again, making that shot a difficult one. Oh, and hit. Made the most out of that foul.
Joe Smith hasn't had many situations. You ever see the pass up here? Simpkins makes contact with Jalen right as the pass arrives. No question about the foul. But down on the other end, Joe Smith hasn't had many nights when he didn't get the kind of look where he can get that turnaround jumper off. But Juwan Howard's right there with him. And he's played against, he played against the North Carolina guys and had tremendous games against the 3-7 footers.
1-1. Is only 1 for 4 from the field. Leon Derrick has come in for the Wolverines. Number 41.
He's going to have trouble with the strength of Booth down low. There's that double down by Michigan.
Rhodes, 1 pass, 2 minutes.
Now, what's going to happen, teams are not used to seeing people double down as effectively as Michigan does in the college level, something that's done so well on the pro level. And what they're going to have to do is start catching that ball and looking opposite, find somebody open for a jump shot.
25-25 with 6:20 remaining, first half.
Some leaping ability, doesn't he?
Having a good game. Both ends. Rhodes. Pipe got in his face when he shot it. Booth. We have not had a shot drop from the field on either side in about 3 minutes.
Well, it's been great defense, Jim. Nobody getting an easy shot.
Smith with the quick outlet, gets Simpkins running, and a push off on the pass.
Give Michigan and Maryland a lot of credit for the way they're getting back in defensive balance. There just are no easy shots out there.
Leon
Mark
Derrick.
Two well-coached clubs.
Leon Derricks with his first. Bostic comes in. He hit a three earlier in this half.
Jimmy, talk about, you know, getting good looks on an offensive end. How about in the NIT last night, Iskaya Jones plays 28 minutes, takes 18 three-point shots, and makes 14 of them. 62 points in 28 minutes. Now, that's with somebody not having a hand in your face.
And for that kind of effort, you get rewarded by going to the Final Four of the NIT.
That's where Kansas State advanced. Well, at least that tied the all-time NCAA record in terms of three-point shots made in the game at 14.
Most points ever in an NCAA tournament game? 1-1, Simmons will shoot one more.
Well, the great Austin Carr.
61. You know, Ohio State.
When you look at Austin Carr's numbers in the NCAA tournament, he had something like a 6 or 7 50-point games, you know, 45 or better. But never got to a Final Four.
Notre Dame only in 1970.
Oh, boy. Simmons went down. Boy, did he hit the floor. Tough young man. The math behind. Oh, he just tripped. It was just an accidental trip.
Tripped right off the heel of Howard.
Hit on that hard floor. He's a tough kid. The Matha High product out of Washington, D.C. School of our own James Brown.
Watch this now, regular speed.
Boy, he really hit the ground, didn't he? But he's out there now. He got up off of that floor. Great man-to-man by both teams. Really well played this first half. Mike can get off a three-point shot if he just get in a little closer. And he's not getting prepared to shoot it before he catches it.
Rose. I say that's an NBA three.
Well, Jalen doesn't have a jumper. He has that standstill Larry Bird type.
Simpkins. With the left hand. Maryland has missed its last seven shots. And a foul called on Simpkins. Almost talked a little too much.
Well, I think Simpkins was thinking about the drive-in that he had at the basket where he felt he was fouled. There's Joe Smith.
Wayne Simpkins is first.
Here you see Fife again with that football player's mentality. He's going to hang in there, and then Dwayne's going to give a little conversation. And I think what he was referring to, Jim, was his drive to the basket.
Well, let's sit down right now. Wayne Bristol is in. 6'1 junior from Beltsville, Maryland. Fife will shoot another one.
Simpkins coming off of that 20-point game and six assists against Massachusetts. So his offense has been sorely missed during his first half, as has Joe Smith.
That 20 points for Simpkins is a career high. Bristol handling it for the first time.
Kind of deal when you come into a ball game, get a couple of touches there. The key of this first half has been the interior post defense by Juwan Howard, not allowing the leading freshman scorer in the country, Joe Smith, to get off. He's got 1 point so far.
Call the foul, hold inside on Maktar Injai.
Second time, Jim, that Maryland against man-to-man defense and the out-of-bounds has been able to go ahead and get something started.
That's the 10th on Michigan, so double bonus. Booth will shoot a couple. Booth 1 out of 5 from the free throw line, 2 for 6.
know you talked about the Maryland getting here the Sweet 16. When you look at their starters, all of them had solid games against Massachusetts. It took that to knock John Calipari's club out. All five starters in Maryland averaging double figures. They had one club, John Lucas captain, that had six guys in double figures. The 1975 team, whistle here. UConn with a 10-point lead, 14 minutes remaining.
All Big East.
They hold on.
You know what's kind of interesting? Florida, you think about, well, they're playing in Florida for the Eastern Regional, but they're playing in Miami, but they haven't played in the building, whereas Connecticut guys go down there at least once a year to play against University of Miami, so they had at least some familiarity with the court.
We saw Rhodes pick up his third. He's also having a tough time from the field, only one out of eight.
Michigan's defense has really shut down any easy baskets that Maryland might get. They've had to work for everything. And with the exception of X-ray hip starting the game with some jump shots, they just haven't been able to score against the half-court defense. See how Juwan pushed Joe Smith out?
And hit on a tough pass to Simpkins. Michigan with a four-point lead.
Juwan Howard just so good at taking away from the deep, from the offensive man he's playing against, his normal positioning. He just pushed Joe Smith out. No foul. And you can see here, Smith, 2 points. The guy who averages right around 20.
Smith, 2 points on two free throws. Rose. Well, he can, on the run, he can put it up as soft as anybody.
He really can. And at 6'8", you know, he puts you to sleep, and then all of a sudden, he can just elevate over the top.
He's got a lot of gears. Sometimes you don't think he lets you know how many he has. You know?
Such an unorthodox.
No. Oh, they call that on Maryland.
Well, that kind of makes up for the one down on the other end. Charge on Jimmy King.
This one called on Bristol.
What you see right now is a young Maryland team starting to get a little frustrated. They're getting nothing out of their offense. Now they're starting to try to do it one-on-one. That won't be the answer.
Timeout on the floor. Michigan with its largest lead.
Meet Greg and Nancy Wagner. They love to cut loose.
Hey, come on.
Obviously, they got themselves a hot, fun-to-drive car.
We got a Pontiac Grand Am.
Exactly. A powerful new V6, sports suspension, a real blast.
Hey, the Grand Am also makes a lot of sense. Solid, got an airbag and anti-lock brakes, standard.
Lots of room for the family.
Yeah, for thousands less than a quarter Camry.
So that fun Grand Am was also the smart car to buy? Can you beat that?
Nope. We are driving excitement,
Pontiac. Tony Gregory, Cincinnati, Ohio, 83,000 miles. Sandy Connell, Atworth, Georgia, 98,000 miles. Jim Bobbitt, Broomall, Pennsylvania, 110,000 miles. We can't promise you the very same mileage these Michelin owners got. But we can promise you this, the very same peace of mind. Michelin.
Time around.
of college basketball. Best male player, best female player. The envelope, please. The Van Naismith Award, Sunday on CBS.
Michigan 34, Maryland 28. Jim Nance, Billy Packer, Jim Gray from Dallas.
You know what's interesting?
Where Florida and UConn are playing, and UConn leads by 6 with 11:35 left to go in the game. James Brown, this game just kind of just sitting there. Connecticut not shooting all that well, Florida not taking advantage.
And give Florida a little credit for the poor shooting of Connecticut. Connecticut only 33% from the field in the second half. The guards of Florida pushing Connecticut out high, forcing them to look a little ugly on the offensive end. Thank goodness, from a Connecticut standpoint, Danielle Marshall is having a good game, 13 points, 11 rebounds, but that's because of the up-tempo when it happens.
All right, we'll see some of this at halftime. Let's go back now to Maryland and Michigan, and Billy Packer and Jim Nance.
Here's again, great blockout. Michigan on a 9-1 run, leading by 6. Final 3 minutes of the half. With this tremendous half-court defense. They just can't figure out how to score. There's that double down.
Ooh. And one. That's a big play for Maryland.
Terrific move. You know, he created that after he turned the corner. Didn't have a shot. Still got it off.
This is the first shot made from the field in 6 minutes for Maryland.
See, there's the double team.
One shot.
By five, he goes in. There's Howard with the block. Booth is able to just control his body enough to pump it and get it back in there.
Njai commits number 3. That's 3 on Njai, 3 on Jackson. Olivier St-Jean will come in.
Thank you.
Gave him a couple of good minutes earlier on in this half.
That basically is the bench, Jim. You know, you just...
What a contrast from last year.
Yeah. You know, Derek's comes in some, but basically St. John and then Doug. Maryland not shooting from the free throw line, and when you're not hitting anything from the outside, those are at least some easy ones you might be able to stay in the game with. Jalen Rose didn't have what he wanted.
Five to beat the shot clock.
Ray Hip is showing some leaping ability in this game.
Ooh. Back with Simpkins. Blocked by St. John.
Then I talked about, and he got
Simpkins knocked him down. Got knocked down. St. John, good player.
And you know, again, Joe Smith, I talked about fire. Their head, you know. Well, I think, Jim, he's so frustrated he's not getting the ball. And he gets an easy one and then tries to slam it down there. And nothing's going. See, those are bad shots. Just great defense by Michigan.
Last minute of the half, Wolverines by 7.
Maryland players starting to walk around a little bit, disgusted in the fact they can't get anything working.
Howard, Smith got a piece of that one, blocked it. Foul going up.
Bristol's getting a lot of shot opportunities off, but they're inside where the guy's just a little bit too big for him.
Jimmy King is third.
And you know, when you think about it, here we're down in Texas, Jim, and where Michigan has done so well with the recruiting, the guy that everybody thought was going to be a starter was Bobby Crawford. Player of the year, Mr. Basketball in Texas, but he really hasn't fit into the scheme.
He got injured, broke a hand in Crawford during the season, during the practice in January, but here's the bulletin at the moment for this team. King with his third. King, Jackson, Njai, all with 3.
I'm surprised with 27 seconds that Steve Fisher doesn't take Jimmy King out. Just to, you know, not pick up that fourth foul and a cheap one.
Two times.
Jimmy will take it to the basket. Draw a charge on Jimmy King on this exchange.
Oh, there it was.
There it was. Shouldn't have been in the game. Now, tough assignment. You figure Jalen Rose is going to come back out and get this ball. A little too late now. I'm surprised he didn't want it. Seconds to go. It's his second. Real good pass by Jalen.
This is his second personal foul.
Here comes, now to take Jimmy King out of the game. Here comes Bobby Crawford.
We saw Michigan play Duke in December. I thought that Crawford would be a little bit more into the rotation. He played a lot that day, but again, the injury in January, and ever since then, he hasn't really been able to work his way into a lot of minutes.
Well, Jim, remember, he started the first three games of the year with 2 for 11, and he had that big game with 5 threes against UT Chattanooga. Had 22 points, but as you mentioned, that injury really cut him back.
Juwan Howard, as he draws the second on Smith, has not committed a foul in this half, and he went 39 minutes against Texas without committing a single foul.
Well, as I said, he is not a shot blocker, but a great position defender, and tonight he has given Joe Smith a real education of what a veteran can do to the inside.
Derrick comes in to hound the inbound pass, 3 seconds and a half to a midcourt shot. And a good one, though. Lucas right over the top. Well, Maryland made only one of its last 13 field goal attempts. One in the last 8 minutes. And Michigan leads by 7.
CBS Sports' exclusive coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship Regional Semifinal Game is sponsored by Pizza Hut, GTE, and by Hewlett-Packard.
Powerful all-aluminum alloy engine in the Lexus ES is so incredibly quiet. You can hear the cliché.
The color and excitement of the 1994 NCAA Final Four by ordering this year's official souvenir program. The 224-page magazine is loaded with team information, NCAA records, past champions, and all the pageantry that surrounds America's number one sporting event. To receive your copy, send $10 to 1994 Final Four Program, 3342 Melrose Avenue Northwest, Roanoke, Virginia, 24017. Please allow 4 to 6 weeks for delivery. This message provided by the NCAA.
This is CBS.
During March, there's something in the air that makes us all act a little strange. Well, at Summit City Ford, March Madness is in full swing. Hundreds of new Fords are on sale at factory invoice. Plus, get factory rebates up to $1,000. Invoices are posted in the showroom. Take out your car or truck, find the invoice, that's your price. Plus, get a factory rebate up to $1,000. There's something in the air, all right, a March Madness sale at Summit City Ford.
Summit City Ford.
Across from Glenbrook Mall on Coliseum Boulevard.
Chicken's so good, it's gotta be Lee.
It's gotta be Lee.
It's got to be that famous recipe.
Oh.
It's chicken so tasty. Chicken so hot. Chicken so fresh. Come see what we've got.
Oh.
It's gonna hit the spot. Come on and give it a shot. It's chicken so good, it's gotta be Lee.
Gotta be Lee.
Oh, gotta be Lee.
CBS.
CBS Sports presents Pennzoil at the Half, sponsored by Pennzoil, the motor oil you can rely on for performance, protection, and quality.
Welcome to Pennzoil at the Half. We're still here in our New York studios. I'm Pat O'Brien along with James Brown. Michigan leads Maryland 39-32, and Jalen Rose stepping up today.
No question about it. Jalen Rose causing all kinds of problems. X-ray hip did a pretty nice job in the early part of the going. I think Jalen Rose is a better ball player as a number three player, a small forward, if you will. That's where he creates matchup problems. He's got, 10 points in the first half? Major problems if, in fact, Maryland doesn't adjust.
And Michigan leads 39-32. Speaking of problems, UConn having all kinds of little problems. They're becoming big problems. They're shooting. They're not shooting very well. They're turning the ball over, and they've allowed Florida to jump back in this game. They're once up by 10. Let's send you up to Vern Lundquist and Clark Kellogg for the call.
8 minutes and 23 seconds remaining in regulation. Donnie Marshall for UConn at the line, shooting the second of two. Gets them both. UConn, which led by as many as 10, then saw the lead shrink to two, has it back to a four-point cushion. Greg Williams has come on now for the Florida Gators with Anderson, Dirkelboten, DeClerc, and Cross.
See, this pace obviously favors Florida, and if it stays tight, I give them the advantage because their guards can do so much damage one-on-one.
Kevin Ollie knocked that away for UConn. Marshall. Marshall again. Greg Williams for Florida. Neither team, you're right, neither team seems to win.
Shoot a couple. Boy, they're really letting them play. Here we take a look at the wild pass by Williams, and then Spain Dirkelboten able to pick up the loose carom off the glass and get a deuce. Nothing like being in the right place at the right time.
Nicely done, Clark.
Well, I've had a tremendous help from you this evening.
What's that Scandinavian background about? Misses. Vane Dirkelboten got the basket. Doesn't score that much. Now, Ray Allen, who hasn't scored tonight, and he averages 13 off the bench for UConn, is back on the court. Donyell Marshall, 7:25 remaining. The lead is three. The UConn Huskies have led throughout since they were behind 5-4.
Make your engine last longer. Change your oil every 3,000 miles and use the newest Pennzoil. Now with a revolutionary Pennstar molecule, Pennzoil works like liquid ball bearings. Clings in, on, around, and between moving parts to reduce heat, friction, and wear like no other motor oil.
My car's got 295,000 miles on it.
It has 161,000 miles.
314,000.
173,000.
Pennzoil has always stood by me. It's never failed me. You got the winning color!
Sure, I'm happy with my new Grand Prix. Anti-lock brakes, dual-air bags.
Really feel safe.
Safe schmafe. Beats me why she only talks safety. I mean, this is a Pontiac.
And what a terrific buy. It was over $1,000 less than the Taurus.
And don't let that value stuff fool you. She's a wild woman. This is a Grand Prix.
With this V6 engine, it's nice to know the power's there when I need it.
Power, yes! That's my mom! To Grandma's! And step on it!
There's a great relationship between officiating and playing, and because it's just as competitive, and it's just as exhilarating, and you get just as much out of it when you finish if you've had a good game. It's the same as you did with a player when you had a good game.
Your ball that way.
It's like playing against a real tough opponent or a real tough team. You have got to concentrate, you have got to work hard, you have got to be at the top of your game in order to do the job that's required that night. And in order to do that, that's competition. You're competing against yourself, against the game, and you are trying to achieve something that's very hard to achieve, and that's working the perfect game. I think the most important thing that an official can bring into the game is 100% concentration.
This message provided by the NCAA.
The Oscars of college basketball. Best male player, best female player. The envelope, please. The Van Naismith Awards, Sunday on CBS.
UConn has turned it over 11 times in this half. Donyell Marshall has scored 14, but the UConn Huskies have gone with one field goal in the last 8.5. And yet, they continue to hold on to a lead. They've not relinquished since they were down by one at 5-4. 7:22 remaining in the game.
Down the stretch here, Vern, what you're going to see is that if Florida is able to keep UConn from getting another spurt because of their guard play, I think they come out on top because they'll get high percentage shots from Cross and Brown. If UConn can put together a spurt, 7-zip, 11-4, then they probably go away winning. Otherwise, I think the edge goes to Florida because of Cross and Brown.
Cross has it now. DeClercq saved that last errant shot. Goes to, oh, the shot is short, but DeClercq gets the rebound, puts it up and in. And this is as close as UConn and Florida have been since early in the game.
Breaking through that barrier is the key for the Florida Gators because it tightens up UConn even more. I think the reason UConn has struggled with handling the ball and not scoring in the last 7.5, 8 minutes is because they're getting a little tight with that favorite throw.
Ball goes to Florida. Craig Brown back in the lineup for the Gators, replacing Greg Williams. Dimitri Hill comes back in, replacing Zane Dirkelbunten.
You know, Hill left at 8:23. The TV timeout came. There was 23 seconds plus the TV timeout, plus another 2 minutes. Ron Kruger getting him ready for the stretch run.
Gets it past the Hill.
Oh, yes.
But he will shoot free throws.
Burns. I would not want to be out there trying to get around Dimitri Hill. When he puts you on his bottom, he'll take you wherever he wants you to go. And that's, see, look at that. See, Johnny Marshall is spun around like a top trying to get around him, and Hill able to get inside.
You know, I think the point should be made about Dimitri Hill that he has been the subject of a lot of humor, not only in the SEC because of his physical shape. This is a marvelously gifted basketball player.
No question about it. Critical juncture here. They've got to pick themselves up and fight through this little period. And I don't know if the fans back in it are going to be difficult.
Holly and Thompson. That ball almost stolen. Donyell Marshall, no call. As Cross went for the steal.
The shot clock still at work, so they'll have to get busy.
Cross goes for another steal. The shot clock timeout. UConn.
obviously keep our eye on this game for you as the night unfolds. We send you back to your game. It's 52-49, Florida, 5:23, and we'll watch it here for you when it gets close to the end. We'll send you back there. Right now, we're going to send you back to the second half of Maryland and Michigan. Thanks for joining us on the Pennzoil at the Half. For James Brown, I'm Pat O'Brien. Enjoy the second half here on CBS.
Pennzoil at the Half was sponsored by Pennzoil, the motor oil you can rely on for performance, protection, and quality.
So, where's the boss today?
Picked up his new car.
What'd he get? The BMW? The Lexus?
Neither. He got the Bonneville.
Really?
Said it had anti-lock brakes, leather, dual airbags. Said with all that and the way it drives, he couldn't see spending 10 to 20 grand more.
He likes bargains.
He likes cars.
Look who's living in Archie Bunker's house now.
You are a bigot.
Black man can't be a bigot, son.
Back to a Korean, Dad.
Some things never change.
We have too many children having children.
You just might be right on that one, son. Because I know one too many that I had.
From the creator of All in the Family, there's an all-new family.
Women are looking for someone who'll say I do. Men want anybody to say I will.
704 Houser premieres Monday, April 11th.
This is CBS.
Kelly Chevrolet invites you to a spring blowout.
March 24th, 25th, and 26th.
An event so big it could only be held at the Memorial Coliseum. Northeast Indiana has never had a selection of new and used vehicles like this before. Incredible deals.
Incredible financing.
Incredible leasing. Cars, trucks, vans, and conversion vans.
Listen carefully. This is the buying opportunity of 1994.
Kelly Chevrolet's spring blowout.
March 24th through 26th.
The Coliseum.
Hey, Jim. New windows?
Looks great, huh?
Pella windows?
Nah.
Didn't you go to the Pella window store?
Who needs them?
They got Pella certified contractors for that.
Who needs them either?
And they would have helped you with that, too.
Oh, yeah.
Pella would have helped you pick out the right sizes.
Yeah, right.
Pella? What is that number?
Michigan leading by 7. There were 8 ties, 8 lead changes, and then Wolverines with a late run, Billy. And how about the Maryland shot chart?
Well, when Michigan turned down the screws, and you look at that shot chart early on, that it was X3 hit from the outside that started off with a bang. But then look at what happened in the last 8 minutes of that first half. Maryland 1 for 13. If you're Gary Williams, you look up there, you're only 7 down. You're probably thankful with that kind of shooting over that long span of time.
Remember, Maryland came back from 10 down in the second half against UMass with 70% shooting second half. Let's bring in Jim Gray. Jimmy?
All right, Jim, thank you. I spoke with Gary Williams, and he said he didn't have much to say to his team at halftime, but he said the same thing a lot. We got to get the ball inside. We got to get the ball inside. He said we're taking too many shots from the outside. We're not a jump shooting team. We're going to try and establish Joe Smith earlier in the second half. Jim?
All right, for Joe Smith, it's a long first half, Billy. 0 for 4 from the field, 2 points on 2 free throws.
Well, Juwan Howard was 2 for 8, but he really set the stage with his defensive intensity and position. Maryland getting into the Sweet 16 shot 58% against St. Louis and 60% against Massachusetts. Here in the first half, they're shooting 32%.
Smith, well, there's a way to get him started.
Well, you know what? Juwan Howard had a frown on his face to say, hey, how come somebody didn't help me out and pick him up there?
Took 10 seconds into the second half for Smith to score from the field for the first time tonight. King at the other end.
Blocked by Smith. Sensational play by Joe Smith after a great touch pass by Jalen.
Smooth driving. Oh, missed the chipping.
I think he thought he was going to have some contact from Rose. King both with 3 fouls. Important for them to stay out of foul trouble here early in the second half. 5 seconds. We never see it, of course, anymore on the dribble, but you can't have the 5-second held ball if you're standing still with it. And sometimes better than throwing it away and having somebody intercept it for a layup.
Hit way too long over the back with Booth. That time X-ray hit probably should have got it down into Joe Smith. For one of the few times had better position on Howard down low. That's the first on Booth. Maryland press not being effective against Michigan anymore. They're throwing it over the top. Of course, they couldn't use the press much because they went so long without field goals in that first half. Howard, they count it, and one. Jawan got Joe Smith on his hip. Here you see it right here. He got him on his hip. The pass came to the right side. Joe Smith went baseline to try to go ahead and get the ball. You'll see it right here. Joe tries to fight around baseline. That leaves it wide open for the move and the drop step inside.
That's the second on Booth. Two quick ones in this half. Three-point play. Howard with 12.
Well, not exactly like 28-34 he had in his first two NCAA games, but going against maybe a little better post defense.
See how hard he had to work that time. He had three Wolverines to contend with.
And you see what Gary Williams' strategy is. He's stepping him outside on the foul line so he can face Juwan Howard instead of playing with his back to the basket, which is a very smart move by Gary Williams. And Smith is capable.
That's four on King, by the way.
Smith is capable of facing the basket. He's just not a low post player. Matter of fact, he probably is already a quality forward.
St. John comes in, and Jimmy King, his third and fourth happen if you lap over into the first half within about 2 minutes of one another on the game clock.
Remember, Jimmy dodged the bullet in that last 20 seconds of the first half. Yeah, when you take a look at some of the things that Joe Smith has accomplished, he's hit 20-plus points 15 times this year and 10 rebounds plus 20 times. He's so consistent.
Smith with five.
When they score, they can get into the press.
St. John back to five. Fife now has 7 points.
Having a quiet, nice game here.
7 points, four rebounds, three steals, and two blocks.
Yep.
Nice, solid game. UConn Florida tied with 3:40 remaining.
There's Joe Smith again out, facing the basket.
Booth.
That's Jackson's fourth. He just used Jackson inside. Too strong for him.
And immediately, Injai comes off the bench, and he's another one in foul trouble. He has three, but
Jim, this is an excellent adjustment by Gary Williams. He stepped Joe Smith outside, which allows Booth to have plenty of space inside, because you can see Juwan Howard is now playing 18 feet from the basket and can't double down.
So the two Texans saddled with four.
Now, you know what happens here? Jalen Rose senses all this. Watch and see if he doesn't have the ball in his hands an awful lot the rest of the way.
How about Booth now? 2 for 9 from the line. And the difference is 7 on the leaderboard.
That's right. Go for it.
Where's your...
Rock Hardy, right? And the leaderboard. It's one and the same.
I'll save that one for 2 weeks from now.
That's right.
Booth.
How about Booth's strength inside? That's going to be on Juwan Howard, I believe.
That will be on Howard, his first, and his first in over two games.
His first personal foul.
Well, Booth has just been so strong inside. There's foul trouble. Rhodes with three.
61 minutes for Howard since he last committed the foul.
Double down now. What Booth has to do is to throw that ball out opposite for somebody for a jump.
Ooh, Simpkins with a save.
Brown again with a nice play. Howard hustling as usual.
St. John really made that, Jim, with an excellent defensive play on the outside. The position defense and the movement of the feet by Juwan Howard. Now watch him. He doesn't ever reach. He moves those feet. May have put his knee out there that time on Booth. His experience paid off.
That's three in this half on Booth. Three in 3.5 minutes.
That ball as he opens for it. Here he is.
2:30 remaining in the East. UConn leads 57-53. A fake. Oh, he knew it, but it left his hands. It was in.
His two buddies are sitting on a bench, and that's when he takes over. This is an experienced club. We heard Nolan Richardson say when we talked to him after his game, hey, Michigan has been to the Final Four. They know what it's all about. They figure out ways to advance. And that's one of them.
That's the third against Hip. So three on Hip, three on Booth. Rose having a tough go of it tonight at the line. He's 1 for 4.
Well, Jalen in the freshman year was the MVP of the Southeast region. Last year he was all Western region. Trying to add to it.
Timeout on the floor. Wolverines with their largest lead. Lead by a dozen.
Half. UConn 49, Florida 52.
The Women's Final Four coming soon on CBS.
Stood there bowling, sweating in the sun. Felt like a million, felt like number one. I could ride, I was strong as I could be. I could ride, nothing ever got to me. I could ride.
Longest lasting trucks on the road. Chevy.
Next play is Flash 87 Blue.
Wyatt! Please, I'd like to try this thing. Call home. Nice to be recognized, finally.
Call now for the revolutionary voice-activated phone card. Only from Sprint.
Will Wood leave Evening Shade to coach in the NFL?
I'm all for it. As much as any wife can be for something that might possibly rip her family apart.
But she's sold.
Then, when Great Aunt Lillian dies...
How are you holding up?
Who's consoling who?
I don't have an aunt. You do.
I do?
Florence Anderson guests on Dave's World after Evening Shade Monday.
CBS Sports' exclusive coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship Regional Semifinal Game is sponsored by Chevrolet Trucks, Sprint, and by All-Sport Body Quencher.
Jalen Rose and company have taken over this game 49-37. We're going to send you out to Miami for the finish of Florida-UConn. Florida down by only two now. Here's Clark Kellogg and Vern Lundquist.
At the line, shooting two.
had a chance to give Florida the tie. Now he'll shoot one more.
I think they called a lane violation, Vern. He was shooting one and one.
You're right.
So he'll get a free look. But, well, he doesn't look very comfortable up there.
He is a 49% free throw shooter for the course of the year. And Florida, 7 of 14 at the line tonight. Doesn't get this one. Ollie's got it for UConn. 90 seconds to go. Winner gets Boston College. UConn leads by 2. They've led by as many as 10. Florida grabbed a 3-point lead at 52-49 some 3 minutes ago.
And then they missed two free throws from one of their best free throw shooters that would have given them a 5-point cushion.
Shot clock under 10. Holly, balance, rebound Brown. 1 minute to go.
Look for Foster Brown to take this shot. You need to do 2-for-1 here. I don't think you want to maximize the clock. You want to have 2 possessions for 1. Won't happen now.
Brown almost lost it. Gives it off to Cross with a shot clock at 10. And Dan Cross will go to the line with a chance to tie it up. Travis Knight, 4 fouls.
Boy, they were fighting the shot clock, and the last thing you want if you're UConn is a foul there. See, the shot clock under 5, but clearly Knight came over the back, and Cross did a nice job to wait for that contact.
Dan Cross, 85% for the season, but 2 of 5 tonight. One more for the tie.
Well, obviously, if he makes it, you play solid D and rebound the ball for Florida. If he doesn't make it, then you've got to foul immediately.
UConn has the basketball, 30 seconds remaining.
Danielle Marshall has not had a good touch the last 4 minutes or so. I think you ride him. Or Ray Allen.
Timeout, UConn. And they take the timeout with 15 seconds remaining. UConn 57, Florida the same.
Blasé.
Passé.
Okay.
Cliché. Obvious.
Tedious.
Frivolous.
What a wuss.
Speechless.
So you've never done nothing. Until you do the full tilt taste of Diet 2. Obsessed.
Possessed.
Impressed. No contest.
Today in America, over 11,000 babies will be born. 2.6 million people will go to the movies. 5 million parents will drop their kids off at daycare. And 36 million of us will get where we need to go in a Chevrolet. Think about it. 36 million. It's just another day in America. And more people will depend on Chevrolet than anyone else.
East of the Texas Hill Country in Austin, there's a place that just won't let you go home hungry. It's called Threat Guild. And here you might find yourself behind a great big chicken fried steak, a mountain of red beans and rice, or even a microphone. So if you go, bring your appetite for a good time and your Visa card. Because Threat Guild might let you take the stage, but they won't take American Express. Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
As the thermometer drops, dangerous crystals can form in your car's engine, threatening to shorten its life. That's why today's Quaker State has engineered intelligent oil. Oil that senses the changing threats in your engine and adapts its own molecular structure for continuous protection. So whenever the driving conditions change, so does Quaker State. The intelligent oil for longer engine life. Chuck Norris has a mission. Teach a child molester the law.
We haven't seen anything yet.
Walker, Texas Ranger, Saturday.
15.3 seconds remaining in regulation. UConn has the ball. They will send Kevin Ollie, Travis Knight, Daron Sheffer, Danielle Marshall, and Ray Allen on the court.
If you're UConn, you try to get it to Marshall. I think you take this shot with about 4 seconds on the clock to see if you can get a second shot in case it doesn't go.
Jason Anderson on defensively. He's guarding Sheffer right now. Here's Danielle Marshall. The clock at 5. Marshall with the jumper. But he was fouled. And he'll have a chance to give UConn the lead with 3.4 seconds left.
Right there on the elbow. Marshall got a good look.
Danielle Marshall is 5 of 6 from the line tonight.
Send you back over to the Midwest of Dallas and Maryland and Michigan. Michigan leads 53-40, with 13 minutes left in the ballgame. And Jim Nance here.
Well, Pat, Mario Lucas hit a 3 for Maryland, cut into Michigan's largest lead. It was 16.
And Jim, Michigan doing a terrific job with Jackson on the bench early on in the second half, and Jimmy King as well. So they have done this with that short bench of theirs, and Rose and Howard have stepped up with their tremendous experience to keep that lead where it is.
We were watching the closing seconds of that UConn-Florida game. We were thinking of Jimmy Calhoun, having been in a few of those type buzzer beater games in this tournament.
That's right. In this very game, of course, they got the great pass and the shot to beat Clemson, only to lose to Duke in the regional final. Christian Leitner's first miraculous shot. He just nothing there to put the ball on the floor against that double team. There's the pass.
Ooh, Lucas was setting up to launch another 3.
But if Joe Smith would have got it out there immediately upon touching it inside, he'd had a good chance for a 3.
Gotta beat the shot clock. Simpkins. And that's on Smith. Push it off. Number 3.
Oh, no, no, no. I think they're going to call Juwan Howard for pushing Smith.
Ooh. Indeed, Billy. His second. Got a technical on Harry Williams.
He has been asking for one since the last timeout. And you're down 13. You're going to the line. Not a smart time. You just had a foul call that puts you in a position to go to the line, and now it takes the ball away, gives them 2.
Seconds left in the Florida-UConn game. It's all tied 57-57. Going to take you back out to Vern Lundquist and Clark Kellogg for the finish.
3.4 seconds remaining in regulation. At this point in the ballgame, UConn has made 6 more free throws than Florida. Danielle Marshall has 1 more attempt to give UConn the lead.
If, in fact, Marshall makes this, UConn goes up 1. I would think Florida would try to inbound the ball to half court and then call their last time out to set up a last second shot.
This isn't doing any good for Danielle Marshall.
No, it certainly isn't. Good point. Icing him just a bit more as players get their assignments and take their position.
Marshall is 5 of 7 for the evening. This will put UConn back on top. Florida.
With that timeout, we'll send you back to Dallas and Michigan and Maryland. We'll keep you posted, of course, on Florida and Connecticut. 55-40, your game. Let's go back to Jim Nance. Jim.
That is absolutely stunning. Here's a guy who will probably be runner-up for National Player of the Year, and he misses two free throws.
Well, Jim, we talked before this tournament started. Were there any guys you could put a team on a back and carry him? Don Yell is a guy throughout the course of the year proved that he was certainly capable, but he has not had a good NCAA tournament.
While we were away, Joe Smith collected his third personal. Maryland down 15. Lucas. Fife holding off Simpkins to get the rebound.
Fife with another solid play. Got a little bit too much size for Simpson. There's a solid screen by Derricks.
Jalen grows very upset that Derricks didn't give him the ball. You know, he's popping out from inside, getting it right where he likes to operate. With Jackson and King on the bench with four fouls for the basket. King and Jackson out right now with four fouls. Howard and Rose have scored 16 of Michigan's 18 in this half.
Well, the great experience of this Michigan club really starting to dominate now. They have totally frustrated Maryland and taken them out of their offense.
Timeout called by Maryland as Michigan sets now a new high lead in this game of 17.
With this time out here, we're going to go back over to the East Regional in Miami, where Florida and UConn are all tied 57-57 as they get set to play the final 2 seconds, 2.4 seconds, actually. Danielle Marshall with a stunning development there, missing two free throws, one and one. And JB, what do you take now?
If I'm Florida, I obviously have the ball in the hands of the guards. Look inside for the big fella if Hill is in there.
See what happens. It's Clark Kellogg and Vern Lundquist.
Officials are, by rule, allowed to use a replay to rectify a scorer or timer's mistake. And this is what happened during the timeout. Tom Rucker, the referee, looked at the replay. You see the time was called with 1.7 seconds remaining. That's Tom Rucker on the left, Dan Crispin, the standby official, on the right. They were checking when DeClercq called and asked for the timeout. They have decided to put 0.7 seconds back on the clock. So Rucker is now explaining it to Jim Calhoun and Lon Kruger. But by rule, Tom Rucker was allowed to correct a timing mistake. There's the proper use of the replay. And they have put 2.4 seconds on the clock.
Exactly. Well done and well documented. Now Florida just wants to get it inbound.
Oh, my! It was almost obtained by Travis Knight.
Well, there's no reason to throw the ball on the floor in the backcourt. You've only got 2 seconds. You got to get it across half court with your pass here. Gator's lucky to retain possession.
DeClercq to Hill. We've got overtime. It took a while, but Florida fought back. They're tied at 57 with the University of Connecticut Huskies. 5-minute overtime coming up.
United Airlines. In 12 cities, in 11 Latin American countries, they're playing our song. Come fly the airline that's uniting the world. Come fly the friendly skies.
Thanks for seeing me during lunch, Mr. Ross.
No problem.
I'll make a couple copies and we can get started.
Fresh, hot McDonald's fries. They're so tempting. What you want is what you get.
Okay, so...
at McDonald's today.
Mr. Barnes, tell me about yourself.
Overtime period will last 5 minutes. Each time is granted one additional timeout, which means that UConn has two timeouts now, and Florida will have one. Overtime is also an extension of the second half. That relates to personal fouls and so on. Well, how many times have there been overtime in the tournament? Single overtimes, 101. Double overtimes, 12. Triple overtimes, 4. There have been 4 quadruple overtimes.
Well, look for Donyell Marshall, who missed 2 free throws that possibly could have given UConn the win, to really look to try to take over in this overtime period, I would think. Florida, on the other hand, blew plenty of opportunities in the last 5 minutes, and yet they too have new life.
Marshall and DeClercq, and it's controlled by Florida. The Gators have Cross and Brown, Jason Anderson, DeClercq, and Dimitri Hill. Last night he was Syracuse and Missouri. Tonight, Florida and UConn. And Dimitri Hill, Travis Knight with the block.
Good help by Donyell Marshall. Hill had nowhere to go with that one.
Sheffer, no. DeClercq to the rebound. Cross running. Or Brown, rather. Throws it right to Jerome Sheffer. At the other end, Ollie. Off his hand, Florida ball. You don't think anybody's nervous out there.
Look, I mentioned I thought Connecticut played a little tight the last 7 or 8 minutes. But Florida unable to really take advantage of that.
4 minutes remaining in overtime. No score in overtime thus far. Hill wants the ball. Brown blocked by Sheffer. Good job.
Solid defense in the last 2 possessions by UConn. Florida has to get into their offense a little earlier. Much easier said than done, because UConn has done a nice job pressuring the ball on the perimeter and collapsing inside. Well, where's Donyell Marshall? They've got to look to find him, and he's got to work to get himself free.
As it now with Jason Anderson guarding him, and Anderson fouls him.
Again, late in the shot clock, Anderson reaches in and gets a piece of Donyell Marshall's arm.
Donyell Marshall back at the line, his mind no doubt preoccupied with thoughts of what might have been.
Mm-hmm.
He's missed his last 3. Including 2 that could have given UConn the lead with 3.5 seconds to go. Huskies up by 1, 58-57, 3:15 remaining in overtime.
Florida has to get into their offense a little earlier. Fighting the shot clock the last 2 trips, they haven't gotten a good shot.
Good defense by Ollie. Timeout, Florida.
And that's their only one. And
Florida calls timeout.
Time is called with 13 seconds left on the shot clock, 2:55 remaining in OT.
A tradition unlike any other. The Masters on CBS. To make the new Chevy S-Series trucks incredibly quiet, foam plugs, triple-sealed doors, and acoustic panels redirect road, engine, and wind noise. Because even the smallest noise can hurt a reputation. The 94 Chevy S-Series, so new from the inside out, everything else is history.
Time around, no dance.
rhythm. Because everything's possible. This time around.
Bare back seat belts and anti-lock brakes. Child safety seats, careful driving, and a set of Michelins.
For his retirement, Neil McBain had no intention of slowing down. That's why Dean Witter mapped out his financial course with only one goal in mind. Victory. Dean Witter.
We measure success one investor at a time.
Among the highest awards for quality in the world is the Deming Award. Very few manufacturers have ever won one. Ricoh has two of them. In fact, Ricoh copiers and fax machines have won every major award for copier and fax quality. So we don't just have a reputation for excellence. We have proof. The name to know, Ricoh.
You are watching the NCAA Basketball Championship on CBS.
The most significant element of this reset is the zero under UF. No timeouts left for Florida. And 2:50 remaining in overtime. 58-57, UConn leads it. Brown, there's the switch. Brown takes the shot, no. Anderson with the rebound. And he is fouled.
Boy, great board work by Jason Anderson. He just elevated above everybody to get that one. You know what's happening right now, Vern? This game has been so herky-jerky in style for the last 13 to 14 minutes. Nobody's in a rhythm. It's going to be a free throw shooting contest, basically. Four shot by Brown fighting the shot clock, and then Anderson times his jump, and then there's the grab by Marshall.
Anderson shoots his first free throw of the night, and he's got a couple coming. Florida is now 10 of 18 at the line. And the sophomore from College Park, Georgia, has put Florida back on top. Back it goes to Donyell Marshall. Off the mark. DeClercq with a rebound.
Let's see if Florida will get a good look at the basket. And to do that, they have to get into their stuff prior to the 10-second mark on the shot clock.
Cross looks underneath for DeClercq. Cross takes the shot too strong. Rebound, Ray Allen, UConn. Under 2 minutes remaining in overtime.
Marshall grimacing a bit, got raked in the nose a possession or two ago.
Sheffer, my goodness, what a shot.
It got partially blocked, that thing, Burns.
90 seconds to go.
I think Jason Anderson may have gotten a piece of that.
Man is a social animal. Man is made to live with others. So, the club is a whole series of human adventures, working toward a better way of living. We all like what is beautiful. We all love what is true. I've become completely attached to the American Express card. It gives you freedom. And heaven knows what that's worth at the present time.
American Express is welcome to Club Med and anywhere else people go to find themselves.
A punctual boy, our son.
Punctual all over the world. UPS drivers are the same. Ask their mothers.
He's not rich.
He's not handsome, but punctual.
He was even born on time.
They're obsessed with being on time, so UPS now guarantees on-time delivery to hundreds of cities around the world or your money back.
If my son says he will be there, he will be there.
It's a guarantee that not only has our driver's word on it, it has their mother's.
He breaks out in a rush if he's late.
We may not be the first to promise you the sun, the moon, the stars. But we may be the first to actually deliver them. Introducing the new Camaro convertible. What else would you expect from the country that invented rock and roll?
At the end of the day, more top mechanics in America choose one motor oil over any other brand to help keep their own cars running longer. Valvoline Motor Oil. People who know use Valvoline.
Hello, I bought it on him.
It's a considerable benefit, and that's the truth. The American Express card is one of the essential tools of modern life.
To get one of the tools of modern life, look for this application and take one.
Tonight,
from on Broadway,
Rosie O'Donnell, Lou Reed, and Neil Patrick Harris.
Run for your lives. It's Bobby Knight with a folding chair.
Gators are up by four at the 1:15 mark. Greg Brown hit a three-pointer. And the Norwegian and the Finn led the Scandinavian skyline to even higher proportions. Here's Ollie.
Percentage shot quickly if you're UConn. You don't want to waste too much time.
55 seconds remaining. UConn, the second seed, down by four. Sheffer spots up for the three. The rebound in the hands of Florida. Trying to get to the Elite Eight for the first time in the school's history. Jerome Sheffer with a foul.
Give them a six-point cushion. Really didn't need the three-point shot, although Sheffer got a good look at one. Just didn't follow through.
This is the largest lead Florida has enjoyed tonight. Kevin Ollie heads out. And the margin came on a three-point basket by the only senior in the starting lineup, Greg Brown. Dan Cross throws a little frustration at himself.
Yeah, an 85% free-throw shooter. He's hovering around 50% tonight.
Four of eight. And the Gators have their largest lead. It comes with 35 seconds left in overtime. Marshall, no. Sheffer, they need the three-pointer. Ray Allen takes it, no. Dimitri Hill fouled in the backcourt. Coach at Kansas State. He got his team into the regional final in that game. They lost to a guy named Danny Manning and the Kansas Jayhawks, who went on to win the national title. This time, he's got his 10-year-old son, Kevin, on the bench as a good luck charm.
He had a pretty good player back then, too, Mitch Richmond, who went on the following year to be the NBA's Rookie of the Year. But the Gators, they win ugly. They don't do anything spectacular. They haven't shot it well from the free throw line, but I think more than what Florida has done, I think it's the fact that Connecticut has been flat and careless, and then I think the weight of being the favorite when they weren't able to put it away earlier in the second half really started to show itself.
minute, 6 seconds remain. The Florida Gators lead by five.
How we doing?
Dave needs to see you.
I'll be right there.
Hey, Ron.
Brad, man, how you doing?
All right.
Brad Johnson has a lot to think about.
Where's my table?
Dave needs in the kitchen right now.
That's why he chose AT&T. Competitive prices without the hassle is his AT&T business advantage.
Hey, Joey, get the big
five. What's up, Dave?
We got problems.
Call a plumber.
So what does Brad think about his long-distance service now? He doesn't.
AT&T works for me.
Let AT&T work for you.
There are over 3 million miles of roads in America. And if you're on any one of them, Chevrolet will be there. Our genuine customer care program will take care of you with a 3-year, 36,000-mile warranty, 24-hour roadside assistance, 6-year, 100,000-mile corrosion protection, free courtesy transportation if your car ever needs service, and the largest dealer network in the country. That's genuine customer care. Genuine Chevrolet.
An annual eye exam means more than 20/20 vision. Your eye doctor may detect diseases like diabetes and high blood pressure. When's the last time you had an eye exam? See your eye doctor regularly. Don't lose sight of what's important.
Introducing Mylantis Soothing Lozenges. For the first time ever, and an acid in the form of a lozenge. For liquid relief as it dissolves in your mouth. New Mylantis Soothing Lozenges. My doctor said Mylanta.
Go ahead, make a wish. Then share it with your Allstate agent, who knows planning makes wishes come true, and who can outline a life insurance plan to assure family security and college funding and a comfy retirement are in the stars for you. So make your wish and trust it to your Allstate agent, who wants to be your agent for life.
Second to none. The battle for the national championship. Saturday on CBS Sports.
Neither team with a timeout remaining. UConn has the possession arrow, but Florida has a 5-point lead with 15.6 seconds left. And Kevin Ollie gets call for the foul. This is a UConn team that is back in the NCAA after a one-year hiatus. They missed last year with a 15-13 record. But it is not a senior-dominated team. There are no seniors in the starting five, Clark.
Yeah, they're a young club. Ray Allen is going to get better. Had an outstanding tournament until tonight, struggled with his teammates as far as shooting the ball, especially the last 22-23 minutes. So, and part of that you attribute to the defense of the Gators, but you have to also make the point that UConn missed some shots and turned the ball over an awful lot when they had a chance maybe to stretch the lead to a comfortable double-digit mark.
Lead is back to seven as Cross hits two. Ollie to Sheppard. Ollie has it misfire. Here's Cross behind the back, and the senior. Points, nine assists, 9 rebounds, and Daron Sheffer for the UConn Huskies. 69-60 the final here. Right now, let's go back to Pat O'Brien in our New York studios.
All right, Vern, thank you. Good job. So that sets up an unlikely final for Sunday, Florida and Boston College. Let's now go back to Dallas and Michigan and Maryland. 4:24 left. Here's Jim Nance and Billy Packer.
Maryland has scored 8 unanswered. And Jim, in the first game against Pepperdine, which Michigan won in overtime, they have a habit of doing that. Jackson and Howard both fouled out.
Get up!
And a rebound by Rose. What a three this is. Tip Howard. And Ray Jackson with the rebound.
Maryland maybe a little over anxious there. Still plenty of time in this game.
All 5 Michigan starters in double figures tonight. They've led by as many as 20 in this half. It's now 11 with 4 minutes remaining.
Down to 10 seconds.
Mike almost had it taken away. Put up a knuckleball. Smith's rebound.
Well, they had the ball in the hands of the one to get it in Jalen Sands to get down low at the clock.
Rose, he hit a big 3 a moment ago.
Down to 9,
single digits.
And now, see, now you've got to ask your starters to pump it back up again, Jim, both emotionally and physically. And they've been on the floor a long time. I don't believe Jalen and Juwan have been out, have they?
Well, they've been playing, I think, the whole second half.
1 minute. We understand 1 minute they've been out of this game.
Howard. And one. Racking up some big numbers again tonight. 24 with 15 in this half. Huh.
Wayne Simpkins, his third personal foul.
There's Juwan with a leaner on the inside. Huge basket for a Michigan team that was having a run put on them. Slices right through. Simpkins not big enough to stop him. Juwan continues his tremendous play in the NCAA tournament.
He's got a double-double already, Billy, with 11 rebounds, and now looking for 25.
Well, he's coming off 28-9 and a 34-18 game. Points and rebounds.
Joe Smith. Blocked by Howard. Is that it? Piece of the arm.
That's his fifth, isn't it?
Here's a guy that is his fifth. He did not commit a single foul in 39 minutes against Texas. And tonight, he fouls out with all of his personals called in the second half.
Now, Juwan better be careful in regard to his language right here. Technical foul would be huge.
Joe Smith, who was silenced in the first half, did not make a single shot from the floor. Now we'll have the opportunity to go the final 2:49 without Howard on it. Timeout called by Michigan. When we come back, Joe Smith at the line for 2, Maryland down 11.
UConn 60.
What do you do when Four Wheeler Magazine crowns you Pickup Truck of the Year? You leap up in the air. You take a bow. And you give the runners-up a big wet one on the cheek. Chevy S-Series, Four Wheeler Pickup Truck of the Year. Further proof that everything else is history. Because everything's possible this time around.
Jim, you got one.
Yeah, hey, this calls for a celebration. How about a Cold Odul?
Thanks.
Ah, only 70 calories and not alcohol. Because out here, you never know what's biting.
When you want the refreshing taste of beer without all the alcohol, think Odul's. It's what beer drinkers drink when they're not drinking beer.
Mr. Gooden?
That's right.
Any relation to Dwight Gooden?
No.
Okay. Do you have time for a couple of questions?
Short ones.
Tell us about your HP LaserJet printer.
My LaserJet?
Yeah, what do you think about it?
I don't.
Ever?
LaserJets work. What's there to think about?
But if you did?
I don't.
But if you did?
Well, if I had to think about it, I probably wouldn't have one.
But you do have one.
No, I have two.
Oh.
Is that enough?
Works for me. HP LaserJet printers. You do your job, we'll do ours.
Good idea.
If you think you've heard everything there is to know about cigarettes, you haven't. 60 Minutes knows something you haven't heard and wouldn't know unless you tune in Sunday.
Billy, Maryland on a 10-2 run. And in fact, with 8:50 remaining in the game, Michigan led by 21. 66-45.
Jim, that's at the point where I really thought it was in their best interest to rest their starters. If they were losing some concentration, take a chance that the subs could hang on for 4 or 5 minutes and work the game on out. But right now, they still have a potential dogfight. If Maryland were to be able to turn the ball over on them any, you know, with a three-point shot, almost three possessions if he hits this one.
Howard is fouled out. Maryland has no timeouts remaining. Smith 4-for-8 from the line. They've missed 17 free throws tonight. Unbelievable.
Trying to double team, turning the ball over now. You expect the ball in Jalen's hands, but X-Ray hits the ball and everywhere he goes, realizing that's where Michigan wants it. Good hands by X-Ray Hip. He stepped in and stopped the handoff.
Lucas in.
3 seconds left in the shot clock.
Lucas comes in, only 3 on the clock. 2:17 remaining in the game, 10-point advantage.
Joe Smith was taken out of the game. Now, without any timeouts, how are they going to get him back in?
How to shoot it. Injai almost made it. Now Maryland, 2:10 to go.
Surprised Gary Williams took Joe Smith out, but without any timeouts, Jim.
Rose, three-pointer. Booth saves it. Puts it high off the glass to cut it to 8.
Or does he have some ability in there to create the shot?
Plays much bigger than 6'5".
See, Jim, here you have, sitting on the side, Joe Smith. They can't get him back in the game. Time's going off.
Down the pipe. Stolen by Rose. Back to Booth to Hip. This is Chippy, gets it back. Hip makes it 6. 1:30 remaining. They've made up 15 points in the last 7 minutes.
They're trapping all over the floor. Jalen Rose finally calms things down.
He is a calming influence for this team when they get in a situation like this.
Well, I think X-Ray Hip is so exhausted from the offensive maneuver, he couldn't go out and chase Jalen. See, he can hardly move. Letting a lot of valuable time go off here.
Five on the line. 57 seconds to go. Joe Smith checks back in.
Jalen telling the referee was hit on the arm a little bit too late there. And now Jalen goes over and has a little conversation with X-Ray and said, you know you hit me. Almost like they're on the playground somewhere.
Booth goes out. Simpkins back in. Simpkins, Lucas, who can fire a 3. Rhodes, Smith, and Hip on the floor for Maryland. Remember, no timeouts for Maryland.
And remember also, the other steadying influence, particularly on the defensive end of the floor, Juwan Howard has fouled out.
The hoop.
push off on Injai. Sends Smith to the line for two.
Not what you want to do, Steve Fisher, because you want the time to go by and not stop this clock.
Bristol and Booth come back in from Maryland.
And wait, Bristol return.
If they hit these two, put them down six, so you're on one of those two possession runs. Jerry Williams wants his team to start thinking about fouling a little bit.
Maryland 18 of 35 from the line tonight. One more for Smith. Cut it to six.
Michigan showed they can make some free throws in the Pepperdine game. They made 10 straight in overtime. Well, now you can expect them to be put on the line here on these inbound passes.
King will go to the line.
That was Bristol's job.
King will shoot two. They're in the double bonus.
Wayne Bristol, his second personal foul.
35.8.
Jimmy King, despite the fact that he's a slashing type player, Jim, when you look at his stats, he's only been to the foul line 74 times this year. 66% free throw shooter. He's a guy that should get to the line much more, don't you think?
As much as he drives, yeah.
I mean, he's capable.
Oh, boy.
Now, here's the key thing. When you've got a guy that doesn't shoot good free throws, you have to be aware of the potential miss and get ready to rebound. So many times we see guys getting the boards. And look at Jalen Rose out here. I'm surprised he's not on the line.
Michigan's missed four straight. A three could make it a one-possession game. Rose, no, I thought he was going to fire it. Here's Simpkins instead. Underneath a push called against Booth.
Pushing off.
That'll be it for him.
Yep.
Just like Howard, Booth committed all five of his fouls in the second half. Well, they had two trips in the last minute, down six. One time they turned it over, this time they committed the foul.
And Jim, what you saw there was almost like a little two-man weave that Maryland set up. I really think that Dwayne Simpkins is the kind of guy that's got the ability, he's powerful enough, low to the ground, to dribble and penetrate inside. It's very difficult to get a weave on the perimeter and then create a three-point shot off it.
Ray Jackson.
Lucas comes in for the Terrapins.
Ray Jackson, shirt out. Whatever happened to that rule, Jim?
It didn't last long.
Now let's shoot in.
Five straight Michigan misses.
I really think Jalen Rose should be over on the lane because he's such a good rebounder. He's got great instincts for the ball. Here he is out at half court, serving no purpose.
About that, this is their last six. And a play by King just to use up a little more time. Good hustle. 21.8 to go. Maryland needs a couple of threes.
Exactly right. A two-point shot is not worth taking now, although the clock will stop. Here goes the weed. They can adjust to that.
Yep. Jackson gets it ahead to fight. Michigan's going to the regional final.
Jim, in Maryland's history, they have often lost to the national champ. 81, they lost to Indiana. 85 to Villanova.
I think there's a possibility here.
My region.
I don't think so.
Curtis Schultz in for Maryland.
I give you something else that when you start going into Final Fours, there have been four teams that have gone to three straight Final Fours without winning.
Houston's one of them.
I'll give you a comeback on that one, though, but Houston is one. They lost in 82, 83, 84, Duke in 88, 89, and 90. North Carolina, 67, 68, 69. And Ohio State, 44, 45, and 46. That'd be tough to do. Wouldn't it be the Final Four three straight years and never have a championship? Well, I'll give you that comeback in Houston because that wasn't a dagger. 10 years ago today, I read it in the paper. 10 years ago today, Houston went to the Final Four by beating somebody in the regional final. You know who it was?
Memphis State?
My alma mater went to
the Houston. Okay.
So there's your comeback.
And they made a great run in this tournament, Maryland. But Michigan's in the Final Eight. The Final Eight now has two from the Big Ten, two from the SEC, and one each from the Big Eight, Pac-10, Big East, and ACC. Here they are, Billy. Purdue and Duke, Missouri and Arizona, set for Saturday. Boston College, they pulled off a little magic at that school one other time down in Miami.
Yes, they did.
Like another sport, though.
Yep.
And he's not a bad ball player. Michigan and Arkansas will meet on Sunday. The right to go to Charlotte.
You're canceled.
How do you get canceled out of a commercial?
You're not getting the ratings, Chevy.
I like this stuff.
Well, keep the bag, Chevy.
You're a sport, Chevy. You look great.
Tough year. Good chip.
Doritos Tortilla Thins. Everything else is just a chip. This is the planet Earth. Popular line of sport utility vehicles on the planet. Chevrolet.
The John Deere 14PZ walk-behind mower has a 5-horse engine that breezes through thick grass. A rugged, lightweight cast aluminum deck. Easy starting. A 30-day money-back guarantee. And over 40 other features you'd expect from a John Deere mower. Plus something you probably didn't expect. A price of just $349. Which means that, for once in your life, you can get more than you bargained for.
Go ahead. Make a wish. Then share it with your Allstate agent, who knows planning makes wishes come true, and who can outline a life insurance plan to assure family security and college funding and a comfy retirement are in the stars for you. Make your wish and trust it to your Allstate agent, who wants to be your agent for life.
Tonight,
I'm on Broadway!
Rosie O'Donnell, Lou Reed, and Neil Patrick Harris.
We sedate Dick Vitale on The Next Dave.
We welcome you back to Dallas. Michigan holds on to win by 7 points. And we are now joined by Steve Fisher, the head coach of Michigan. You're up by 20 points. And what happened to your team? It seemed like they lost concentration there in the last 10 minutes.
We did hold on barely. It was almost like we wanted to have another 5-point game so we could add to the record, I guess. We weren't very good down the stretch, and we must be better against Arkansas. But we get a chance to play them.
That is the point, but what do you tell your team now? You got to go from feeling very good about this victory to not feeling very good at all.
Oh no, I feel good. I feel great. We're in the great eight. We're playing for a chance to go to the Final Four. Nobody said this game was perfect, and we proved that. We played well in spots. We played well to get a 20-point lead. We were abysmal as they came back. You can't do that. But I'm going to go in and say I'm proud of you. We'll come back, shoot some free throws tomorrow, talk on Arkansas. No, I'm not going to dampen my enthusiasm for this victory. I'll take three more just like that one.
I understand you will. Congratulations. We look forward to seeing you on Sunday.
Thank you.
Jim?
All right, Jim Gray, the Chevrolet players of the game. Booth, Keith Booth from Maryland, who had 17 points and 9 rebounds. Juwan Howard from Michigan, who had 24 points, 15 of them coming in the second half. Michigan finds a way to win. That's been their pattern. Win and advance. One more win, and they're going to the Final Four. Pat O'Brien, James Brown coming up when we continue on the road to the Final Four.
A tradition unlike any other. The Masters on CBS. Camaro. What else would you expect from the country that invented rock and roll?